we have already learned in the 9th class. Now when we can see these polygons are similar when the corresponding angles, let's suppose this is the A, B, C, D, E and this is P, Q, R, S, T. Here one of the polygon A, B, C, D, E and another polygon P, Q, R, S. So when we can see these two polygons are similar, when their corresponding angles are equal, means angle A equals to angle P will be there, angle B equals to angle Q, C equals to R, angle D equals to angle S and angle E equals to angle D. Means when the corresponding angles are equal and when the length of their corresponding sides means AB corresponds to angle which one? PQ, BC, QR, correct? When the length of their corresponding sides are in proportional, then we can say that these two polygons are which type of polygons? Here similar polygons. Okay, now if you have to say the similar triangles and its property, right? You know that everyone knows the properties of triangle, correct? So besides here, if we take one of the example for the similar triangle, right? So we have discussed already in this basic. So if this is the triangle, correct? With a different measurement angle, it is not necessary. This is the equilateral triangle. So here we take this is three sides are different in a length. So similarly here, okay. Third one, next one triangle measurement. Sides are different in a length, but here these angles are in a equal measurement. If we extend this from all the sides, if we extend the length of all the length of from all the sides, so measurement will change, but angle of measurement will not change. So when we can say these two figures or these two triangles are similar when their corresponding angles are equal, correct? Corresponding angles are equal to measures and the length of corresponding sides are in a proportion. Okay, length of the corresponding sides are in a proportion. So, how to write the proportion? AB by PQ equals to BC by QR and equals to AC by PR. Then you can see the sides are in a proportion, then when all these ratios become same. Then we can say these two triangles are similar. Now we will see more basic result on the proportionality theorem. So on this theorem is the basic proportionality theorem and this is also for the Thales theorem. Now we will see this. Here the statement of basic proportionality theorem is Thales theorem. Right? So sometimes in the examination they will ask state and prove the BPT. State and prove the basic proportionality theorem or state and prove the Thales theorem. So Thales theorem and basic proportionality is same, right? Sometimes they will give the statements of the theorem, we have to prove it, right? So what is the statement? If a line is drawn parallel to the one side of triangle intersecting the other two sides, then it divides the two sides in the same ratio. Okay, now see. If a line is drawn parallel to the one side of triangle, means you have to draw one triangle first, correct? So here one triangle is drawn. Okay, this is the triangle. Line L, which is parallel. one side of triangle BC intersecting the other two sides. Intersecting means this line is intersect to the other two sides of this triangle ABC. These two sides, sides AB and AC. So this line is intersect to this side. So part of intersection will take this D and this E. So DE, right? So DE parallel to BC here. This line F is parallel to BC and this line F or this is DE intersect other two sides. This other two sides is side AB at point D and AC at point E. Then what we have to do that? Then it divides two sides in the same ratio, right? You know that after this, after the E, the statement it is given, and after the then, that statement that we have to do that, right? So what we have to do? It divides. Who divides in this? It means this D, or you can say line L. It divides these two sides in the same ratio. Exactly, you have to do that. The ratio is AD upon DB is equals to AD upon EC. Okay, now we start to this theorem. So here, what is the given? It is given that DE is a parallel to BC. DE, or we will write in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, DE is a parallel to what? BC, and its intersect. Intersect the AB at point D and AC at point E. Intersect AB at point D and AC at point D point E. Okay, so this is the given in this statement. If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle intersecting the other two sides, then it divides the two sides in the same ratio. So we have to, what we have to do? So to prove the ratio will become same. So what to prove? AD upon DB equals to AD upon EC. Okay, now for this to prove that the ratio is same, so we have to make some special constructions in the figure. So we have to join, first we have to join BE, okay, and here. So before joining this DC, I will show that, see, because of this DE, right, and joining this of BE, see this type, this part of this figure. Okay, this part of the figure, this one of the triangle, but in this triangle there are two triangles are formed. This triangle ADD and triangle BDD. Correct? Understood? Even this triangle ADD and triangle BD. Right? Now, if you join this BC, then if you neglect this, then what? Means remove this, then this also one of the part. Whole it is a triangle, but again it is divided into two triangles, means here AD and triangle, this triangle DEC, this triangle also is there, right? So here you have to make the construction join BE and DC, right? So construction join BE and DC. Okay, also we have to make another special construction. Suppose we will take this triangle, so we have to draw one of the height for this triangle. So here, this will take EF. We will draw EF perpendicular to this. A, right? E BC perpendicular to both AC, right? So another construction is what they are. Draw EF perpendicular to AB and DG perpendicular to BG perpendicular to AC. Understood everyone? Now with the help of this, if you think we will prove that AD by DB equals to AD by EC. Okay. Now we take this triangle. First, we can select this side AB. Okay. On side AB, before drawing this, I have shown you how many triangles are formed here. Triangle ADE, right? And another triangle BDE. So, first we will find here. Now we will start proof. Okay. So, here, when we start proof, here, since EF, now we will take this EF, this is the perpendicular on this side. This is AB, right? So EF is a perpendicular to AB, right? Since EF perpendicular to AB, this EF what will be there? Since EF perpendicular to AB, then what will be the EF? EF is the height of triangle, which triangle? AD, and also EF is the height of triangle BDD. See here, I am drawing this A and this is B. Okay, one of the sides is here, this we have done BE. Okay, so this is the one of the triangle. This triangle from E point we have drawn for perpendicular. So, of course. Perpendicular is always the height of the triangle. So ADE triangle having what is the height? EF, right? And here if you take this BD, here we have triangle, correct? In the construction we have triangle here. So what is the height of this BD? Of course, the height of D is EF, because if you take this, so here any triangle. This is obtuse angle triangle. This is obtuse angle triangle. This triangle B, D, E. Okay, BD is obtuse angle triangle, and always the obtuse angle triangle having the heights are which perpendicular we have to draw. So perpendicular is not possible to the inside. So here this is the height. Okay. So EA. So this EF is also the height of triangle BD, right? So we will write the area of triangle BD. Here we write EF is height. Okay, now we will find the area of triangle. So now here area of triangle. This triangle first we take triangle ADE, right? Triangle ADE is equal to what is the area of triangle? Yes, half into base into height. So here half into base. Base is what? AD into height. Height is what? EA height. Triangle ADE having the base is AD. So AD into height is what? EA. So half into base into height. This is your first. Now, secondly, we will take on the same side another triangle is triangle BDE. So, we find also the area of triangle BDE is equal to the same half into base into height. So, half into what is the base? Base is what? BD. Right? Into height. Height is same for this triangle EF. Okay. This is now if we take the ratio of these two. Right, AD, area of triangle ADE, area of triangle BD. So we write the area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle BD. equals to here. We will write this one. Area of triangle half into AD into BA. Half into AD into EF upon half into BD into EF. So this gets cancelled. So you will get area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle BDE is equals to 4 AD upon BD. Right? This you got 12. Okay. Similarly, now we will take this side. This side AC. Right? Similarly, here. Now we can take directly the ratio of these two triangles. This triangle ADE having this side, so ABC having this side is AC. So on this side, which two triangles are there? Same AED, AED, D, and another triangle what? CED, or we can say DEC. Okay, so here area of triangle AED upon area of triangle CED. Area of triangle CED is equal to the same. What is the area of triangle AB? How it is height? So now on this side, which one your height? DG is your height. So for this triangle AB, right? For this triangle AB, for the base A, what is the height? Height is your DG. Understood? So here, half into base. This is what your AE for this triangle AED. AE is a base. So AE into what? DG. DG is the height. Okay. DG. And upon here, the same half into what is the base? Base is what your EC. Into height is what? The same height is here because this form here. The obvious angle triangle, so height will come outside the triangle, so that is the DG. Correct? So now here, this gets cancelled, so you will get AE upon EC. Okay, this is the fourth statement you got. Now, actually, we want what? Area upon DB equals to area upon EC. Area upon DB equals to area upon EC, that we have to prove that, right? Now you can see these two triangles properly. Which triangle? Area of triangle BD. Which triangle? BDE and triangle CED. Right? So where are these in this figure? Triangle BDE and triangle, which triangle? CED. CED. Right? Now these two triangles, see here. This BDE and this triangle CED. These two triangles are on the same base, which means that DE, right? If you see the lower part of this figure, so these two triangles BD and triangle CED are on the same base DE, and between the same parallel, which two parallels? DE and BC. So last year we have learned about the property for this, right? When the two triangles are on the same base and between the same parallel, so area become same, right? So according to that, we will use this property. So area of the two triangles or area of the two triangles on the same base and between the same parallel become same, right? So by using this property, we can write here triangle BDE and triangle CED are on same base and between same parallels. Okay, between same parallels. So area become same. Okay, you can write what? Area of triangle BDE is equal to area of triangle CED. Right? Now that will take the reciprocal of these two triangles, two sides reciprocal we will take, right? So it will take the reciprocal. What is the area of triangle? What is the reciprocal of this area of triangle BD? So when we take reciprocal before reciprocal, there is a denominator is 1. So reciprocal will come 1 by what? Area of triangle BD, right? So here 1 upon area of triangle BDE is equal to 1 upon area of triangle CD by taking reciprocal. Okay. Now after taking the reciprocals of these two triangles, we have to multiply with the area of triangle ADE. Okay. So here, after multiplying area of these two triangles, after I multiply for these two sides by area of triangle ADE, so you will get what? ADE 1 is 1 by area of triangle BDE into area of triangle ADE. Okay. So is equals to here similarly for this side 1 upon area of triangle CED into what? Area of triangle ADE. So now students see here, when you will multiply this ADE to these two sides, one upon area of triangle BDE and one upon area of triangle CD. So you will get what? Area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle BDE. And here area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle CD means you will get area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle BDE, correct? Right? And here equals to area of triangle ADE, you will get area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle CD. So I will write here. Area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle CED, area of triangle BDE is equal to here area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle CED. Area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle CD. So what is area of triangle AD? Area of triangle CD, or we can say area of triangle CD. What? Area of triangle AD upon BD is equal to what? AD by BD. Right? So here AD by BD is equal to here area of triangle AD upon area of triangle CED. Here you will get what? AE upon BC. AE upon BC. Okay. Then we have to do. So we will write here as 3. Now we will see the next. Now we will see the 5 important results related to BPT, that is called corollary. First, BD by AD equals to EC by AE. Second, AB by BD equals to AC by EC. Third, BD by AD equals to EC by AC. Fourth, AB by AD equals to AC by AE. And fifth one, AD by AB equals to AD by AC, right? Now, as we have proved in triangle ABC, one of the sides is parallel, is supposed to be DE parallel to BC here, okay? Okay, so we will try to
draw this figure of your triangle.
Okay, so in this triangle, triangle ABC, BE is a parallel to BC, then AD by BD equals to AE by EC. Okay, so here, as we have proved by BPT, as we have proved by BPT, in triangle ABC, what D is parallel to BC? D is a parallel to BC. Then what result we got here? Correct. AD by DB. AD by DB equals to AE by EC. AE by EC. This statement, by the means in the BPT theorem, we got this AD by DB equals to AE by EC when DE is a parallel to BC. Now, as we have proved this, okay, so how you will prove this BD by AD equals to EC by AC? When you will start for this group, just only we have to write as we have proved, right? What AD by DB equals to AE by EC, right? Then on inverting, this result we will take as a first. Okay, only the result of BPT, right? On inverting, the above means this is the statement of by BPT, right? So what you will get? DB by AD equals to EC by AE, right? So DB by AD equals to EC by AE, and this is your first corollary that we have proved with the help of BPT. Understood? So BD by AD equals to EC by AC. Now we want AB by BD, right? AB by BD means BD means downside. For the denominator, BD should be there. So here in main theorem, you will get AD by BD equals to AE by EC, right? So this is by taking, we will take this by taking BPT result. Okay, by taking BPT result, what? AD by DB equals to AE by EC. AE by EC. Okay. Now, how we have to put that AB? AB is for the numerator and BD for the denominator. So, we have here BD for the denominator and for second, EC means EC for the denominator. Only numerator we have to change. Okay. So, it should be what? AB. So, when AD becomes AB, then AD plus DB, when you will add in this AD to DB, then you will get AB. Right? So, for that purpose, what we have to do? We have to add what? 1 on both sides. Okay, so here AD by DB plus 1 equals to AE by EC plus 1. Okay, now AD ones are AD plus DB ones are DB. So AD plus DB upon DB. Correct? Equals to AE ones are AE plus EC ones are EC upon EC. So AD plus DB. AD plus DB equals to what you are? AB, right? So here you will get AB by DB equals to AE plus EC equals to total your AC. So here AC by EC, and this is your second corollary. This we have to with the help of your BPT theorem, right? So you got this AB by BD equals to AC by EC, right? Now third one, BD by AB and EC by AC. If you see this properly, this statement, third and second and third. So here BD, AB by BD, and here BD by AB. Here AC by EC equals to here what? EC by AC means what is for the numerator, that is for denominator, and so on. So if we will invert the second result, then you will get this third result, correct? So on inverting, we will write on inverting which result? This second result. Second result, what you will get? DB by AB means BD by AB. Okay, so BD by AB equals to EC by AC. This is your which one result? This is third result. Okay, now we have to prove that this fourth one result, AB by AD. Okay. So here where AD is denominator for in this all the corollary, here AD denominator is here, correct? We want AD, and here E, E is the denominator is here. So we have to take the result of this here, means we have to take the help of this first result, that's in afterwards we can prove this fourth one result, right? So we will take this what? BD. By taking all the right what? By taking first result. Okay, what is the first result? BD by AD is equals to EC by AE. Okay, now what? When BD becomes AB, when BD becomes AB, we want this is the AB and denominator AD is there, right? So in BD, if you add in BD, if you add AD, then you will get AB, right? So for that adding AD, here we have to add one, then you will get the same, right? So here BD upon AD plus 1 equals to EC upon AE plus 1, right? Now here BD ones are BD plus AD ones are AD, right? So BD plus AD upon AD is equals to EC plus AE upon AE, correct? So BD plus AD, BD plus AD equals to AB, and EC plus AE equals to AC, right? So here you will write what? AB by AD equals to AC by AE, right? So here your fourth one result ready for us, correct? This AB by AD equals to AC by AE. Understood everyone? Now what about the fifth one? If you see this, again you will get the idea. Here AD is denominator, here AB is numerator. AB is the numerator, AB is the denominator. Similarly for this, correct? Na? So on inverting this result 4, you will get the result 5. Okay, so by inverting result 4, what you will get? What is the result for this? AB by AD. So on inverting, you will get AB by AB equals to AB by AC. And this we have proved, correct? So this is your fifth. Understood? Okay, now we can see the converse of BPD. Here, if the line divides any two sides of a triangle in same ratio, then it must be, this line must be parallel to the third side, right? Now, according to the statement, we will draw first your figure for the converse of BPD. This is the triangle ABC. ABC. Then intersects AB at point D and AC at point E, and so on. It is given that the ratio is same, right? So same ratio is what? AB by DB, right? AB by DB equals to AB by EC. AB by EC is given that, right? Now what to do? What we have to do? Line must be parallel to third side. We have to prove that D is parallel to BC, right? So here, BD is parallel to BC. Okay? Now we start. Now we have to prove that D is parallel to BC. So in triangle, by repeating, we have the AD by BD equals to AE by EC. That we will take the help of this statement. Now here we will take the help of D by D means AB by BD equals to AE by EC, and we have to prove these two lines are parallel to each other. So let possible we will take this D is not parallel to BC, because we have to prove that D is parallel to BC, right? So here we will draw the another line which passes through point D. D and it intersects AC at point A. This line we draw from the point D and it intersects AC at point A, right? So first we write for the proof that if possible, DE is not parallel to BC, because we have proved that. So DE is not parallel to BC. So DF is another line that passes through this point D and it intersect at F. Okay. Now here let DF is parallel to BC. DF is parallel to BC. Then by repeating here, what will be there? Then DA is parallel to BC. By basic proportionality theorem, when any line is parallel to the one of the side of triangle, then it divides the other two sides in the same ratio. So according to that, what will be there? AD by DB, right? So AD by DB equals to AF by FC. AF by FC, right? By BBD theorem, right? But actually, what is given here? You are given AD by DB equals to AD by EC. It is given in the statement, right? But AD by DB equals to AE by EC. AE by EC. Okay, now if you see this two statement, here AD by DB equals to AE by FC, and here AD by DB equals to AE by EC. So here the left hand sides are same. by LC equals to AB by AC, right? So here, from first and second, AF by LC equals to AE by BC, correct? Now, we have to show that what AE is a parallel to BC. Now, what we can do the next step? If we add here the 1, right? So, we have to add 1 on both sides. Now, what is the result you will get that we see? Okay, AF plus AF by FC plus 1 equals to AE by EC plus 1. AE by EC plus 1. Then the same what AF on the A plus FC on the FC is AF plus FC upon FC is equals to AE plus EC upon EC. Okay, AF plus X equals to what? AC, right? So this is AC upon FC is equals to, now AE plus EC. AE plus EC equals to AC, right? AC upon EC. So now we are in this both the side, the numerators are come same. So of course what denominators also becomes same. So here this is your third statement, and from third we can